we're building the new Melbourne Conservatorium of Music. So it's a new music school for Melbourne University. It's a really important project for them because it brings together a whole lot of different facilities into the one building and really upgrades the facility that they have now to something that's really world class.
The conservatorium is going to have three large spaces. The one I'm really excited about is on the ground floor. It's their orchestral rehearsal space, and that can seat 120 musicians in full flight, or if we roll out the seating, 200 seats, we can have an audience of 200 and a small chamber orchestra, about 60 to 70 players. The second space is a more intimate 400 seat recital auditorium, and that's where we'll have our chamber music, our recitals, our early music, our new music ensemble will also perform there, and we'll have vocal concerts and vocal ensembles in that space as well. And then we've got a stunningly designed space for more intimate performances, but for also a high quality recording space where we can have our staff and our students produce really high quality, high definition recordings. When we first started talking about this building and talking to the architects, I mentioned that I didn't want the building to be a monastery. I wanted it to be a living, breathing space.
Part of the design strategy is a philosophy that we want to connect the conservatorium with the wider arts community. Behind us is a 6 metre diameter window, which is the oculus. This allows vision between the street into the orchestral rehearsal space behind us. And through this big gesture, this big 6 metre diameter window, we're creating this curiosity from the outside in and the inside out. Each performance space is a concrete box, and within that, we have another second isolated internal box that is all sprung. What that does is create isolation between the internal spaces and stops the noise getting in from the street to allow for that beautiful quality of sound that the performers require. So where we're standing is under the cantilever of the music workshop, and what we're going to create here is an external performance stage, which we're calling the Rotunda.
Having the entire music program based down here in Southbank is going to be really quite exciting because it will allow us to connect with all the other music organisations in this part of the city. The Melbourne Recital Centre is just next door. That's where our elite ensembles perform. Across the road, we've got the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra. We collaborate with the MSO to offer a Master of Music in Orchestral Performance. We're the largest and most comprehensive conservatorium in the country, so we have students of all types, from violinists, pianists, vocalists, jazz musicians, composers, musicologists, ethnomusicologists, interactive composition students. All of those students will have access to these facilities to rehearse, perform, and record their work. The university's been offering music since 1879, and the conservatorium building on Royal Parade in Parkville was opened around 1903. So we've been waiting a long time for our new facility. I'm really excited that next year our students, our staff, and the city and Australia can celebrate this amazing facility.